Hello everyone, Treecks here and welcome back to Driver, you are the Wheelman. Last time we got started with our job interview for the undercover missions, the story mode of this game. And today we'll be actually starting the story mode. We are going to crawl into the skin of John Tanner, an NYPD detective who's going to try to find something wrong in the underworld. Apparently there's this major crime boss in New York by the name of Castaldi. And he is up to something. However, above ground, we can't really find out what that is. He's very good at hiding. So the police have decided to infiltrate. And we, as the best driver in the police, are the best man to do it. We are going to enlist ourselves as a getaway driver and try to get our name for ourselves and hope we are able to get this guy's attention. But first, we need to make a name for ourselves, like I said. Let's see if somebody has reacted to our ads in the papers for a getaway driver.
You have one new message.
Apparently they have. As you can see, we can use this answering machine in order to get jobs. Basically do the missions of this story mode. We only have one message right now, so we can only play the message or accept the mission immediately. But let's just hear what we need to do.
It's us. So listen. We want to use you on a bank job. No hassles. Should be real sleepy. You want in?
A bank job, eh? Sounds easy enough, simple to start with. Just get to a bank where a couple of dudes have robbed the place and we need to get them out. Okay, let's get ourselves introduced to how undercover works. Here in Driver, as you may have noticed from the earlier parts, we have a couple of mini games, you might say, that we played in the previous jobs. These undercover missions are going to take them to practice. And expand them by a lot. Because this first one, the bank job, actually is going to ask us to go to some place. In this case, a bank. So you can kind of compare it to the cross-town checkpoint, you might say. However, unlike that, as you can see, we actually need to go to the other side of town. It's a lot further away than we are used to. But basically the same deal. This is what's known as the go-to missions. Just go to a certain location in time. Because, of course, it is timed. Where would the challenge be if we weren't? So this is what the majority of undercover is going to be like. Basically all of the quote-unquote missions we have been doing in the driving games, in side missions, in the mini games, called whatever you like. All the things we have been seeing there, you can kind of see coming back in undercover. But of course all of it has been poured into a quote-unquote story, so to say. So in this case, we're not randomly just going to the other side of town. No, we're actually going towards a bank in order to get some criminals out. Because we are, of course, a getaway driver. Pretty basic, simple mission to start with. I'm pretty sure you are the one who went through the red light. Not me. It's not like I'm ghost riding or anything. Okay, here's the bank. Oh, too early. Careful for that. Apparently these guys aren't done stealing the registers yet. But yeah, you don't want to be into our location too early, because if you do, you actually receive some felony. Because the alarm will go off, you will get felony early. We don't want that. You get it now no matter what, still. Would have been more if we entered that arrow earlier. Okay, now we need to go to a lockup, which is in Miami Beach. Looks like it, so... Let's get ourselves to the freeway and make our way there. This time we're not timed, as you can see, the time goes up, but we do have felony now, so we have a risk of running into some cops now, which is going to be the challenge of the second part of this stage. It's no longer just a go-to mission, it's also a chase mission, where we need to make sure the cops don't get us. Because, of course, there are multiple ways to fail these missions. One of them being running out of time, which is not a problem now, because we don't have any. We can do it as long as we want. However, we can get destroyed, of course. Whenever our damage bar fills up entirely, we also fail. And that's what these guys are for. Don't mind our passengers sometimes saying, "Lose the tail, man!" It's pretty funny that there's... some voice clips here and there, once in a while, here in this undercover mode. But you don't need to listen to them. I don't need these guys to tell me that we need to lose the cops, I know that on my own. Okay, this guy was pretty easy to get to shake off. Hopefully we won't see another one, because usually in these chase sections of missions, you do need to have lost the cops the moment you arrive at your destination. Otherwise you'll get a warning: first lose the tail, otherwise you can't finish the mission. It looks like we're not meeting any other cops, so we are done. Let's crash into the wall to end things off. And that was the first mission. And that is how Undercover works. Let's continue to the next one. Because as you can see, you can just press continue, and if you do, you will simply move on to the next mission if there is another one attached to this part of the story. Otherwise, you get thrown back into your motel, and you can listen to your recording of your answering machine.
You have two new messages.
And apparently we got two messages now. Let's go listen to the first.
It's me. You did good. We got a real hot car. We gotta get it out of here by afternoon. We need plates changed. Respray, man. We need a whole workout. Get yourself down here if you want the work. But this car is hot, man. I mean real flame grill, super hot.
Okay. Interesting, we need to get rid of a car, because apparently the cops are chasing it. However, as you may have heard, we actually get two missions now. If you want to hear the second one, you can press this button in order to go to the next message, and you will get another mission. Yeah, there's split pathways in this. I, of course, because of this being a 100% Let's Play, will cover all of them. And the way I'm trying to do this is go to the first mission, finish off everything until the pets meet up again, and then I will go out of Undercover and return to this point and do the next. Of course, I will cover all of the missions. But that second one will come later. First, I need to cover this first one. The guy was apparently satisfied with our doings with the bank job, so he's going to enlist us again, and we need to hide the evidence. There is a car in the north end of town, and we need to get rid of it. Because the cops are looking for it, and these guys don't want that. So we need to get rid of this car. Take it to the breakers. And where is that? That's a pretty long way. And that's going to be cops chasing us most of the time. So at least we're not timed. But our goal... Oh, no. Can't really avoid that guy. Okay, quickest way is to go through here. But there's bad news here, of course. You can already notice it here. It is pretty narrow here. We don't really have a lot of room. So, making sure you don't get hit by cops here. Especially if they're oncoming. If they start coming from the other direction, that can get troublesome here. Usually, because of this still being early game, the game is pretty lenient. Don't really throw too many cops on our roof quite yet. Something that will happen later a lot more. Okay, here's another one. This one's also going our way, so should be able to get past him easily, because he first needs to turn around. And that we can use in order to get by him. But you can understand that whenever cops come from the other side, it can get a little bit more troublesome. Because these guys usually don't hold back, and you can get hit pretty hard head on. So, therefore, I think I'm going to go to the much more broad highway over here. Which we can do by going over these bridges here. Which is supposed to represent Star Islands, I believe. In real life Miami. And like I mentioned in the earlier parts, this map is not the true Miami, of course, but it is trying to mimic it. So, most of the important sightseeings are here: Miami Beach, Miami Downtown, Star Islands, and stuff like that. You can kind of recognize those still in this in-game city. Okay, we're almost there. Make sure we don't screw up in the end. I'm pretty sure we need to lose this guy first, so hopefully he'll destroy himself. computers are usually not that great early games, so cops usually are pretty good at destroying themselves. Case in point. Trust me, cops won't stay idiots. Get out of my way. There we are. Okay, let me take a look at my mission tree quickly. Looks like I still need to continue, because there's another mission attached to this one, and after that one, we get back on the main pathway, and then I can go back to the split pathway. Okay, hold on a minute. Okay, here we are. Let's continue. I'll just cut that out. I had a couple of issues not related to this Let's Play, by the way, but something other came up. But I'll just cut that out. Let's just move on. Because like I said, there's another job going to be attached to this mission.
You have one new message.
Just one message, okay. Let's hear it.
We want to talk to you. The marina on South Point. We'll just hang loose till you get your ass round here.
Okay, pretty fake. They just want to talk to me. Okay, let's just go, as long as they're paying. That's what we're doing this for, right? It's not like we're actually a cop who's trying to infiltrate in a criminal organization or anything. Case for a key. Mission 3. At least on the regular pathway. And it seems we're going to ride around in the dark for the first time. Kinda noticed this already at sandbox mode. Okay. Pretty early on at Miami Beach. Just take the freeway. Easily gotten to. But anyway, I kinda mentioned this already at the take a drive part of this game. You can actually switch day and night. And so far, just hasn't come up yet. Most of the driving minigames you don't really play at night. In fact, I don't think you play any of them at night. So we didn't really got the chance to see it there. But as you can see, there's actually a day and night system in this game where you can switch around manually whenever you're playing on your own. And even in Undercover, this is actually used. Some of the missions take place during the day, like the previous two. Some of them at night. Some of them actually at dawn or dusk. And this one seems to be dawn. I'm not too sure. Just to kind of look alike sometimes. This looks like dawn a little bit more than dusk. But fun fact, these are actually two times that you can play it. It is not selectable in Take Drive. You can only select day and night there. This in between section, the dawn and the dusk forms of whatever time of day you're playing are actually non-selectable whenever playing on your own. Driver 3 is actually the first game where you can actually choose between dawn and dusk. Driver 1 and 2 you can only select day and night. Even though the Undercover missions do sometimes use dawn or dusk, as you can see, because it's becoming a little bit more light now, so this kind of proves that this is dawn, early morning. Okay, so another one. I'm not too sure if this mission actually requires us to lose these guys. I'm pretty sure it does, so but I also don't want to damage myself too much, because there's something else coming up in this mission. This is the first mission that's going to introduce us to something else, namely stages in missions, continuing missions. But first, let's go continue, because we get a cutscene now.
Need you to make an exchange. This case for a locker key. It's a sweet deal. Cash for a key, in and out, wham, bam, boom. Meet them at the marina. Get the key or stay out of town.
Okay. Apparently that is what we need to do. But besides that, Let's go check out what I was just talking about. Stages in missions. This next part, as you can see, continues from where we were. Not just the location where we were, but also the damage and felony we had. Yeah, we need to go to the marina, just like the guy said. Good to see he wasn't lying. Would have been funny. Get to the marina to exchange this key for cash. And then we need to go to a completely different side of town. That would have been funny. But no, the marina is where we need to go. On the east side of downtown Miami. But this is actually the reason why you don't want to get too much damage or too much felony at this stage. At the first stage, I mean. Because the second one actually continues with the same number of damage and felony you finished the first one with. So make sure you are still able to finish off this mission. If you finish the first stage of this mission with extremely high damage, then this one kind of becomes impossible. So it is advised if you don't do the first part with low damage or relatively low damage, then start over. Same deal you might say applies here, because that kind of hurt. I'll just move on. Okay, that guy's out of my hair for a while. Let's not make sure I don't get hit by other traffic now. That's of course also ways to destroy yourselves. The cops riding around here is not the only way. Come on, it's not fair. I'll just continue. It's not going to be easy because yes, there's going to be a third part as well. But first cutscene time.
Get the case, Seth. Nothing personal, buddy. Take care of him, and I'll see you back at Dodge. Seth? Seth?
Ooh, we got our first kill. But of course, since we're dealing with criminals, of course these guys screw us over. They want to keep their money and get the key. But we're no fools. The only thing that's foolish about us is the fact that we're doing this with high damage. But like the guy talked about, we're going to Dodge Island now. Which is going to be pretty troublesome to reach with this high damage and felony. Because it's once again going to send us across a very narrow bridge. It's pretty hard to avoid stuff, and I don't really have any room to permit myself a lot of mistakes. So, yeah. The fact that I was high damage didn't really help here, but getting turned over, falling on your side, or even upside down actually also counts as you being wrecked. In this game, it's pretty much impossible to get right side up again the moment you flip over. The moment you are flipped over for a couple of seconds, then you will also get the message, you have wrecked your car, game over. And this was kind of what I was scared of, the fact that I've a little bit too high damage and therefore this might become troublesome. Okay, this guy's going my way at least, so I should be able to get past him the moment he turns around, thank you. There's too much stuff here that can wreck me. Oh no, okay, I was able to survive. But I don't think I can live through another one. Please go away. Thank you for screwing up. Because there's a turn coming up, and if these guys are really close beside me, it's pretty much impossible to make this turn without them ramming me, so. Okay. Oh! I did not deserve to live there. But since I did, I'll just continue. Okay, let's not screw up this turn. Let's go. This is the route you need to take here. This is a pretty industrial island, as you may know. And it can be kind of maze-like, but this is actually the path you need to take in order to get to the point the mission wants us to go. Okay, there we go. And you were thinking you could get away with the money. In fact, we even got here sooner than you, while you were the one riding the boat, and therefore you might say he had to be here earlier, but okay. Let's not question the video game logic here, and let's just get our key back. Okay, and with that, we've got our key. Took a little bit more effort than we were supposed to, but of course these guys were trying to screw us over. We're dealing with criminals after all, but still. That mission has been done. And at this point in the game, you actually meet up with the other mission again. I might throw up a mission tree in order to make it a little bit more clear where we are in the game. But this is actually the point where things meet up again. And it is also where I will stop playing, and next time I will return to Undercover, and I will not move on from this point. I will return to that point where the answering machine gave us two missions to choose from, and I will take the other pathway until we meet up at this point again. That is my plan for next time, because I can see 20 minutes have been reached. So, for today, this has been it. Thanks for watching, and I will see you next time in Driver. Treecks out.